In this tutorial, we'll walk through running and serving large language models through ROCm-enabled vLLM with Docker on AMD's MI300X GPUs. First, we'll use FastFetch to verify that we have 8 MI300X GPUs available. To optimize performance, we'll turn off automatic NUMA balancing. Then, we can just Docker pull the latest ROCm-enabled vLLM Docker image from AMD's Infinity Hub. The Infinity Hub is AMD's one-stop shop for Docker images that come pre-installed with ROCm-enabled tools for AI development and deployment, HPC, and scientific computing applications. After we download the image, we can run a container from this image, making sure to specify the correct flags so that our MI300X GPUs are available to our container. We are running this container in the CLI and opening it with VS Code. Once we're in the /app directory, we can see that the ROCm vLLM container comes with three notable subdirectories: ROCm profile data, tuned gem CSV, and vLLM, which of course is where the installation of vLLM is located. An up-to-date version of this directory can be found on GitHub. Once we dive into this directory, we can see that vLLM comes with benchmarks, examples, and some other tools. We'll go into the examples directory and run some essential vLLM example scripts. Before we get started with this, however, we'll run ROCm SMI to confirm that we can access our MI300X GPUs from within our Docker container. We also show that this container comes with a conda environment that is set up with Python 3.9, as well as all the necessary packages for running vLLM. Then, we can simply run the offline inference example, which uses a 125 million parameter model provided by Facebook. By default, vLLM downloads models from Hugging Face if they are not provided locally. The model successfully generated a sequence of tokens for each prompt in this example. That is, vLLM used this model to perform inference in an offline setting. It is easy to swap out models in vLLM. We'll perform offline inference again, this time using the 3 billion parameter version of Meta's Llama 3.2 model. This model does require an access token to the Hugging Face API, so we set that environment variable. Be sure to also request access to this particular model in browser on the Hugging Face hub. And we can see that vLLM generates responses using Llama 3.2. Of course, a key feature of vLLM is that it provides an API for efficiently serving AI inferences. It is easy to get started serving on a local host with vLLM serve, followed by the model name. Using ROCm SMI, we can see that vLLM is only utilizing one GPU. We'll use curl to confirm that the API is working and to query the available models. The vLLM API is completely swappable for the OpenAI API, so any of your applications that currently rely on the OpenAI API can easily be hot swapped for your own vLLM server. To demonstrate this, we can run the OpenAI completion client example. Naturally, this output is not very human readable, since it outputs an object representing a complex JSON response with many different attributes. So instead, we can run the OpenAI chat completion client example. This returns a much more readable output, since it utilizes the messages parameter. We can even modify this example to see what Llama 3.2 3b can tell us about AMD. After a bit of cleanup, we can see that this response is pretty accurate. Finally, we can take advantage of all 8 MI300X GPUs by running our vLLM API server with tensor parallel inference. This is especially useful for extremely large models that may not fit in the memory of a single GPU. We can enable parallel inference with the tensor parallel flag. Running ROCm SMI once again, we can see that all 8 GPUs are being utilized. And finally, we can run our example just as we did before.